Hello students, today we are moving on to module 4. We have already discussed the basic terminologies of trees. So tree is a nonlinear data structure that represents a hierarchical relationship among the various data elements. So this is how you see a tree. Next. Trees are used in applications in which the relation between data elements need to be represented in a hierarchical model. Okay. Each element in a tree is referred to as a node. Okay. And these nodes are connected using links. So this is a node. So we can see those A, B, C, D, etc. up to M. We can call it as nodes. Okay. The topmost node in a tree is called root. Okay, so this is the root element. And a tree is a finite set of one or more nodes such that there is specially designated node called the root, and the remaining nodes are partitioned into n greater than 0 disjoint sets, that is t1, t2, tn, where each TI are called subtrees of the trees. Okay, suppose if this is the root, we can see T1, T2 and T3 are the subtrees of this tree. Okay, so these are partitioned into different disjoint sets. Again, B is partitioned into 4. Okay, so this is the structure of a tree. Node, root. Each node in a tree can further have subtrees below its hierarchy. So we can discuss various terms or various basic terminologies. We have already discussed what you mean by a degree, level, and depth, height, all those. Okay. So leaf node. Leaf node means it refers to a node with no children. Okay. That means the terminal nodes, those are known as the leaf nodes. Here E, F, G, H, I, J, L and M are leaf nodes. A subtree means a portion of a tree which can be viewed as a separate tree in itself is called a subtree. A subtree can also contain just one node called the leaf node. Okay. Trees with root B contains nodes E, F, G and H as a subtree of node A. So we can see here this is the root node and we can say B is the subtree of this A. Okay, it's a hierarchy. Okay, and it which is having again a set of nodes E, F, G, H. Okay, so we can call it as a subtree. So we can call a single node. If suppose B doesn't have a partition, only B, then also we can call this B as the subtree of A. Okay. Children of a node. The roots of the subtrees of a node are called the children of the node. Okay. For example, E, F, G and H are children of node B, and B is the parent of these nodes. Okay. Degree of a node means it refers to the number of subtrees of a node in a tree. Okay. So we are considering a single node. So what is the number of subtrees of that particular node? Suppose if we are considering A, it is having degree 3 because it consists of 3 subtrees B, C and D. And if we considering B here, it consists of 4 nodes. So we can say it is having degree 4. So likewise. Okay. So degree of node is C. Degree of node D is 2. Okay. J and K. Okay. If we consider this K consists of L and M. Okay. And of these all degree of nodes, which is having the highest degree? So that can be called as the degree of this tree. Okay, so this degree of the tree is 4 here. Edge, otherwise a link from the parent to a child node, is referred to as the an edge. Otherwise we can call it as a link. Okay, when we are implementing it using linked list, there will be a confusion in the term link, so that we can call it as edge. Okay, so there will be an edge to connect two nodes in the tree. Siblings. Siblings means it refers to the children of the same parent. Okay. A is a parent which is having children B, C and D. So we can call these B, C and D are siblings, because they all are partitioned from the same root or same node. Okay, same parent. And if we considering B is the parent of EFGH, so that we can call EFGH as siblings. H and I are not siblings, because those both are having different parents. H's parent is B and I's parent is C. Okay. Internal node or intermediate node. Okay. Otherwise non-terminal node. Leaf node is otherwise known as terminal node. Okay. So internal nodes are known as the intermediate nodes between the root and the leaf nodes. Those all are can be called as intermediate nodes. Here the leaf nodes are these. Okay. And the root is A. So the intermediate nodes are B, C, D and K can be called as the internal nodes or non-terminal nodes. Level of a node. Okay. Level of a node means as you move down the tree, the level increases by 1 and the root always lies at level 0. So it will be like this. It is at level 0. Next one is at level 1, level 2, level 3. Okay, so there is a difference in the terms which we discussed in the last class. That is, level starts from 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I said you like depth is also same as level. So, but in some textbooks it is like depth and height are same. Okay, what is the depth of the tree? Depth and height are same. And this depth and height means level, maximum level plus 1. Level always starts from 0. So this tree is having level 3. And depth means it refers to the total number of levels in a tree, or we can say the maximum level number plus 1. Level 3 plus 1, that is 4. So depth of the tree is 4. Height is also the same. Depth and height are same. Is it clear? So you can just find out some what is the depth of the tree, which are the nodes, which nodes are children of node B, like this. Okay, so you may do it. Okay, answer is also here. Defining binary trees. So we have discussed what is a tree. Next, we are moving on to binary tree. What do you mean by a binary tree? Binary tree is a specific type of tree in which each node can have at most two children, namely left child and right child. Okay, so correct, when we consider a particular node, it should have two subtrees only. Okay, at most two children, not must. Okay. Either it can be a leaf node or it can be a single child, or maximum it should have two children. Okay, a left child and a right child. So there are various types of binary trees. One is strictly binary tree, full binary tree and complete binary tree. So let us see it. First one is strictly binary tree. A binary tree in which every node except for the leaf nodes has non-empty left and right children. Okay, so when we are considering a node A, it consists of a left child and a right child. Okay, since this C is a leaf node, it can be stay there. Okay. If we consider B, it can here it, the subtrees or the left child is D and the one is E. Okay. And if we consider D, H and G. Okay. That means if we consider a node, it should consist either zero child or two child. Okay. If it consists of a single child, it is not accepted in the case of strictly binary tree. Except for the leaf nodes has non-empty left and right. Not left or right. Non-empty left and right children. Okay. This is very important. They will ask different types of binary trees. So you have to demonstrate it with some examples. Or they will give you some set of nodes and tell you to construct a strictly binary tree, complete binary tree and a full binary tree. Okay. Next is full binary tree. Full binary tree means a binary tree of depth D that contains exactly 2 raised to D minus 1 nodes. Okay. So here the depth of the tree is level 0, level 1, level 2. So depth is level 3. Level 2 plus 1. So depth will be 3. So 2 raised to 3, that is 8 minus 1, 7 nodes. So this consists of its maximum number of nodes. That means if we consider every node, it should be complete. Okay. If here we complete A. Okay, then B, C, okay, then B and C, then B, if we consider B, it should consist of D and T, C, F and G is there, so we can stop there, it's a full binary tree. Suppose we started one element here, D, there is a subtree for D, then its level changes, so its depth will be 2 raised to 4, is it? Here it is level 0, level 1, level 2. Again a subdivision is here. It will be level 4. That means the depth will be 2 raised to, level 3. So the depth will be 4. And 2 raised to 4, 16 minus 1, 15 nodes will be here. That means again there will be a left and right for D, left and right for E, left and right for F. And left and right for G. Then again 8 nodes will be here. 8 plus 7, 15 nodes. That makes a full binary tree. Is it clear? And the last one is complete binary tree. Complete binary tree means a binary tree with n nodes and depth D whose nodes corresponds to nodes numbered from 0 to n minus 1 in the full binary tree of depth k. That is, this is a complete binary tree. Okay, that means when we are aligning these elements, okay, it should complete the leftmost the same. We should complete it from, when you are constructing a complete binary tree, A is there, then B, then C should be here. Not you can place the C here. You should complete left and right properly. Okay. Then D, then E, then F, then G. Then if next an element F came, sorry, H came, it can be connected here. Then also we can say that is a complete binary tree. Because you have completed the last element here as left child. Here it's okay. Because left child is there. There is no right child. Okay. And if you consider this one, it's an incomplete tree. Because the element G is placed as right child. When you, after E, when you get some element not G, you have to place it as left child first, then only right child. You have to complete it properly, left, right, right, likewise. Okay, hope it is clear. Okay, thank you.